Welcome back to Podcast, the vinyl edition. Back up in this once more with some new records. Lots of records. So many records right now. you have no idea. That is a familiar logo to those who've been around for a while. Yes, it means I signed back up for Vinyl Me Please and am again receiving records from them on a monthly basis. And so you can probably expect that to be the deal for until they do something. I'm like, I'm tired of you putting out whack records. Like next month's record from when I record this is a whack record and I don't want it. But if they give you something dope to swap it for, we'll be okay. But for now, you know the deal. What's in the box?
I saw you with the box. What was in the box?
What's in this particular box? It is Ricky Rosé. Oh, look at that. That's new. They have been giving us stickers, people. They have never been giving us that. Rick Ross's Teflon Don. I appreciate Rick Ross. I'm not a huge Rick Ross fan, but they did nice by this one. Look at that. That is absolutely gorgeous. Nicely embossed and so forth. It's a matte cover otherwise, but that is quite nice. But let's take a look at the, of course, Vinyl Me Please of hip-hop, rap and hip-hop track always gives you a nice little stencil. Yeah, it's really nice. Comes on this lovely smoky vinyl. And I appreciate Ross. I don't know if I know Ross enough to say we're going to do some things with. We'll probably play MC Hammer because I'm aware of MC Hammer. This one was ordered quite some time ago. Took forever to get here and kept saying it was shipped, but then every time I go to try to see if it had shipped, it was saying still at the post office, still at the post office, still at the post office. The last day when it said it was still at the post office, it showed up on my deck, on my porch. Still at the post office for this particular record is a lie. But look at this interesting little tape job. What's going on there? That's weird. But I'm still kind of excited to have this. This was ordered the day it went on sale. And, you know what? This is way nicer than my man Seth Micey was super not happy about this, this record's packaging, but I fully understand this type of packaging because I have several records that come like this, including another Kanye record. This is Kanye West's Jesus is King album on beautiful. Do you see how pretty this blue is? Blue vinyl. And yeah, again, I ordered the day it became available. And well, it took a very long time for it to get here, but all of Kanye's records seem to take a long time to get here. I think I'm just gonna blame Def Jam for that. Love the production on this album. Not a big fan of it lyrically, but I definitely will spin you my favorite song over here, which is Water, which is just gorgeous. It's an amazing track, and I'm more than a little bit excited to play that for you. This last guy is from Discogs, and it is a, I'm gonna call it a white whale of records that I've wanted. It costs way too much, but I finally was just like, well, we in the apocalypse, and I ain't paying for parking right now. I'll just come out the pocket and buy this bad boy finally. And it came all the way from San Francisco, and the guy who sent it did not give me any shipping information. He swore it was in the Discogs descriptor that it had shipping information. It did not. But it's really well packed. It is described as near mint on Discogs. Let's see if it holds up to that. Reason it's not mint is because it has been opened, and he did say he played it, but he has brought to me in very good shape. Odysseys, Odd Seasons. Odyssey released a series of mixtapes some years back called Odd Seasons, Winter, Spring, Summer, and Fall. And Fat Beats of Mellow, Mellow Music released it on vinyl, and I could not get it. And I'm always, I just kept looking at it, This one in particular is comes with a bonus 7-inch, which I'm very pumped to have. But I'm just excited to have this record, and I'm excited how this guy packed it. It's very nice. He did a good job with this. So I can understand why he, you can understand why it's not perfect, because like I said, you can see a little bit of a mark on the back there, where kind of vinyls does that. It kind of pushes against the packaging. So near mint is probably, and there's a bit of a crinkle right there, but I have wanted this for so long, and I'm super excited to call it my own, to have it a part of the collection now. And I don't know what I'm gonna play you off of that, because I love everything on it. So here, let's just flip it. We're gonna play Pick 'em and Guess 'em. If I'm gonna play you anything, it will be. Goodness gracious, I'm not gonna lie to you. I truly do love all this. I'll play you City Life off the winter side, because like I said, autumn, spring, summer, winter. Again, I have wanted this for years on vinyl. I have it, of course. When it was released digitally, and they came out. I believe they came out, the releases were seasonal. They were like mixtapes. They came out seasonally. And then when it was complete, they put out a completed, you know, CD and LP of it. And it's very nice, and I'm very excited to have it. Like I said, that right there has been something I've chased for a very long time. And I finally just accepted out that I was going to pay the cost and be the boss on this particular one. And so I did. And I'm quite happy to have it. So listen to some music. See you in a bit. And hey, now we're back to record some music. As you can see, the setup has changed a bit. The old receiver died, the little pile receiver that I had for years, its left channel went out, so it's been replaced by a lovely Yamaha stereo receiver. And so this will be the first time we film using that, but also, as you can see, kind of shifts things and makes things a little more, I don't know, difficult to set up, so I can get everything in a shot. But we'll see what we can do. First record, of course, we're going to spin is this Rick Ross. Isn't that nice? Really, is it? Really does look really nice. Assuming this is side B, because everything's written on it, or do we assume this is side A because everything's written on it, and thusly this must be side B? Well, we will figure out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tracks on that one side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tracks on side A. So this must be side A. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides on side B. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is side B, which is the side we want, because we're going to play the third track on side B, MC Hammer. You will hear it. And if you know Ross's work, you'll know that particular song. We're gonna do some tweaks, some things. Things are gonna be going on here, so forgive me if I have to quickly grab the volume and so forth. Also, I see there's a little fuzz on my needle, on my stylus. But weights in place, new recording setup in place. Let's see what we can do. Ooh, I can see the fuzz. Sounds
fucking amazing. I want to know what place they got that pressed at. I can probably look it up. Well, you can definitely look up where they what facility they pressed this at. That sounds fantastic. Let's give it up to Vinyl Me Please. Look, man, there are those who speak ill of Vinyl Me Please because they don't like how they don't like their business model is what it comes down to. But let me tell you something. When they put out a record and they put some work into it, do you hear how clean that sounds? That's amazing. Well, I am more than a little happy to have that in the old collection. Let's lift the needle there. Yeah, that's great. Wowzers. I'm going to be upset if this next record does not sound as good as this one does. Oh, boy. Next record is, of course, Jesus King by Kanye West. Kanye West is, many of us know, has fully embraced his Christianity, and that's okay. You know what I'm saying? He has never claimed anything to the contrary. He has always said he is a Christian man, and what finally happened is he was like, you know what, I'm gonna go hard for my faith. And that cannot be mad at, you know. Excellent. The song I want to play is, of course, the first song on side B. It is Water. This song almost made me cry. The track is so good. Lyrics, I'm not a big fan of saying pure like a newborn daughter. That sounds gross to me and sexualizes a child. You can be pure as just water or pure as the driven snow. Also, associating purity with virginity is whack, and I've always thought that was trash. That's a weird thing about they do in faith, and I think it's unnecessary. But the song itself is flim flamming gorgeous. So I'm gonna let some water rush over you. I'm gonna give that about. Again, I'm getting used to the volume on this. It's like new, so forgive me for not knowing how to have it dialed in. If it's too loud, I'll pull it down, right? I'll drop it down. But if it's not loud enough, we'll go the other way, so forth, so on. But it's nice to be able to just drop the needle on the beginning of a record for you, at the beginning of at least a side. And let you get a groove going. Jesus Christ, it's so good. This is what I bought the record for. This one song. I don't like most of the songs on here. They're okay. Well produced. But this is the one. So let me tell you something. This is a $40 song. After shipping. It kind of hit me in my ducks again. Like I said, it's something about that song that is so wonderful. It's the only way I can describe it, that it literally it touches something in me that almost makes me cry every time. And the first time I've spun this record, so of course it's a new experience, and so of course that kind of gets at me. But wowzers, it really is something amazing. It's water. Man. Whew, okay. We're gonna move on from that one before I get a little upset. God, that song is so good. When I realize most of us, some of us are not going through it well with Kanye currently. And it's not because of his faith. That's another thing. People would argue, it's because he's a man of God. I'm like, nah, bro, he's always been a man of God. It's really because... it's because we don't think he's healthy right now. We worry that his mental health is causing issues, and we want him to be better, because a better Kanye is probably better for everybody. And if a better Kanye means less or no more music, I'll take it, because I'd rather him just be healthy than not be. I said I was going to play you City Life on winter, but I'm definitely going to play you Birds and Bees on spring, because I... really, 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 really dig that song. So let me see, that's autumn, winter. This is summer, spring. Sorry about that. Again, this was my white whale. This record was something I... how's it winter, summer, autumn, spring? That's a weird layout, but whatever. I super, super duper, duper, duper wanted this record. Because, like I said, I'd had the of course, the mixtapes. And I just didn't have the money when it first came out. And missed it. And by the time I could get it, it had gotten so expensive that I just, you know, I couldn't justify it. But here in the lockdown... I'm not paying for parking every day, or gas every day, or lunch at the office every day. So, I mean, I could afford it. Or I could argue I could afford it. I'm trying to find that spindle, which, what is going on that I can't just drop this record? Oh, goodness gracious. I'm going to reach for my... just give that a quick dust off. Again, remember, near mint. Not sealed in box, so I want to just get the dust off of it. And yeah, if you don't got you a record brush or a nice just kit for cleaning off records, probably should do that. Get on that. We're gonna play you second track on the spring side of this here long player, Birds and Bees, Odyssey, Odd Seasons. Let's fuck with it. So I can drop that just so. Hey, oh. Fellas go. It's mostly an instrumental set of tracks, but every now and again, somebody will jump on the mic, and it is a really, really, really delightful. I'm not saying I'm a huge Odyssey fan, but I fuck with Odyssey a bit. That's the Odd Tape, another mixtape release. This one is kind of nice. It's like if you look at it, it's on a real pretty. Kind of spiral vibe vinyl going on there. A little tie-dye situation effect going on there. Again, on Mellow Music, because that is my man's label of choice. Yeah, like I said, this is something I have wanted for years in the collection on vinyl. And I am very, 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 very happy to finally have it. And... that's what's up, people. I hope the new setup sounds good. Again, like I said, we've kind of shifted everything around the room. I got some new speaker stands. I don't know if you can see those, but that's pretty great. The speakers sit a little higher and at an angle, so they can hope to get a little breath going through them. And everything does sound nice in the house, so I want you to understand that that all has worked out. We've been working on a plan. I don't know if you can see. I don't think you can. But if you're looking at the actual record collection out here, we've been working on a way to alphabetize them in a bit of a way. And so I have a bunch of just, you know, useless is to say, whatever, unplayable records that I got from like dollar bins and so forth over the years. And we've been putting some labels on them and making those the actual dividers in my record collection. So that's a project I actually wanted to do forever and just kind of gotten lazy on or whatever. My kid was like, why don't we try it this way? And I was like, that makes perfect sense. And so he himself has been doing it. Just been sitting down here. He'll get some time. He'll be sitting at the table and he'll just grab one of the records from the pile that of the unplayables and go through and slap a sticker on it. And so we are alphabetizing the record. The records are alphabetized, but we are dividing the records in their alphabetical situation with actual records in it. I think it looks pretty great and it's working out pretty good. So that's what's going on in my own personal vinyl collection. Again, respect due to Odyssey for this record for Odd Seasons. I'm so happy to have it in my collection. If they ever do a reissue, I would tell you to jump on it. Or if you are willing to, you know, spend a couple of bucks on Discogs, I would tell you to get it from there as well. Worth it. Worth every dime. And I'm happy to have it in my collection. Because it's dope. But that's going to do it for this particular episode of a podcast, the Vinyl Edition. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.